described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
TMW Media Group presents Zero the Math Hero, Pythagorean Theorem. In the dark.
Psst. Hey, math fans, over here.
Lit by a flashlight.
Secret Agent Zero at your service. We have an exciting mission today in Lesson 8. We are asked to find some missing lengths for right triangles by using a formula known as the Pythagorean Theorem. That theorem is named after the Greek mathematician Pythagoras, even though the concept was used long before he was born. But be careful, math fans. Try not to get trapped by some of those right triangles. Don't worry, I'll try to help you keep things straight. See you soon back at math headquarters.
The light is shut off.
Hey, who turned out the light? Go ahead and turn the light back on now. I'm not kidding. I really don't like the dark. Hey, Sub-Zero, can you turn the lights back on, please?
Title: The Pythagorean Theorem. Back in the light, in front of a whiteboard.
Here we go again, math fans. Let's look at one of the most important theorems in geometry, the Pythagorean Theorem. We'll call this our Theorem 5. It says that for a right triangle, the sum of the squares of the lengths of the legs is equal to the square of the length of the hypotenuse. We represent this relationship with the equation a squared plus b squared equals c squared. Let's look at a picture of a right triangle here so we can define some of its parts. Of course, it has one right angle that you see. The side opposite that right angle is called the hypotenuse. Here we use the variable c to represent its length. The other two sides are called the legs, and we usually use the variables a and b to represent their lengths. It really doesn't matter which one of the legs is represented by the a or which one is b. Just be sure that you know that the hypotenuse, the longest side, is always across from that right angle. Now, we can illustrate this theorem by using the figure here. This figure shows a right triangle with side lengths labeled A, B, and C. The length of each side of the triangle matches the length of each of the squares, so A has a length of 3 units, B is equal to 4 units, and the hypotenuse C is 5 units.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.